Now, the important thing to understand, to be able to figure this out here, is that if the Boolean formula has a satisfying assignment, then a shortest path from A to B that visits all vertices can visit each of these vertices by basically paying just one extra edge. So instead of going this way, we have to go this way exactly once for each clause. So the length of the shortest path from A to B that visits all vertices is the same as the shortest path from A to B that does not visit the clause vertices plus M, because we have to pay one extra edge for each clause vertex that we visit here. So it's something plus M, and we know that there is a path between A and B that visits each vertex exactly once. And so the path length from A to B is almost the same as the number of vertices, it's just one less. So you can see this here in the example. If I have two vertices, then the shortest path between those vertices is one, so one less. If I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices, then the path has length 4, and so on. So what we have here is 5n plus 3mn plus 1, and then we have to add m. So our total here is 5n plus m plus 3mn plus 1. And now we are almost done. So we have shown that if the Boolean formula has a satisfying assignment, then the length of the shortest path from A to B that visits all vertices has length 5n plus m plus 3mn plus 1, where n is the number of variables and m is the number of clauses. Now we also have to show the other direction, of course. So if there is a shortest path between A and B of length 5n plus m plus 3mn plus 1, then each clause in the Boolean formula can be satisfied. So we have a satisfying assignment. Right now we have shown that if the Boolean formula is satisfied, then we have a path of this length. And now we need to show the other direction as well, of course. If we have a path of this length, then the Boolean formula has a satisfying assignment. Why do we need to show those two directions? That is because the requirement for reduction is that our new instance that we constructed here is a yes instance if and only if this Boolean formula up here has a satisfying assignment. So right now we have shown the if, and now we need to show the only if. But this is actually quite easy, because if we know that there is a path between A and B of this length here, then we already know that each vertex is visited exactly once, because this is the bare minimum of a tour between A and B, given this many vertices. Secondly, we know that the tour will correspond to a variable assignment, so it will correspond to an assignment of true and false to these vertices here, because otherwise we would visit a city more than once, we've already shown that. And finally, we have also shown that each clause can be satisfied, because we can only visit a vertex down here, like that, with paying just one extra edge, if the assignment up here corresponds to a satisfying assignment. And now we are almost done in showing that shortest tour is NP-complete. I don't know if you noticed, but there's one small detail missing. Right now, we're only going from A to B, and we're asking for a shortest path from A to B. We are not asking for a shortest tour yet, but that is actually quite easy to fix. We'll just remove this vertex B here and make this edge very, 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 very long over here. And then it's not the length of the shortest path from A to B anymore, but it's the length of the shortest tour. And of course, that length is only true if and only if the Boolean formula is satisfiable. And we're done. We have reduced SAT to shortest tour. We have shown that shortest tour is in NP. So now our final conclusion, this problem here is NP complete. And of course, it's a bit ironic that showing that a problem such as shortest tour is NP complete can sometimes feel like solving an NP complete problem in itself. That's why I would now like to show you how to even further simplify that problems are NP complete.